Lorraine Judith Nantes arrived in the world 2 months prematurely on September 20th, 1959, to Ralph and Judith Nantes. The family had been visiting Tijuana at the time, and had it not been for her maternal grandfather's amazing driving skills, she might not have made it all the way to Chula Vista, where she was born.
Laughing and running, hey, hey, skipping and jumping, in the mist.
Over the next 7 years, the family grew to six, with three girls, Lorraine, Susan, and Barbara, and one boy, Tommy. The family lived in Lakewood, California. Although her mother was Jewish, Lorraine was baptized and communionized in the Catholic faith.
Going down to the old mine with a transistor.
She attended first and second grade at St. Pancratius Church.
The rainbow's wall, slipping and sliding.
She and her sisters and brother spent most of their free time playing outside with the other neighborhood kids in what Lorraine describes as a very typical 1970s middle-class lifestyle.
Do you remember when we used to sing?
Thanks to her paternal grandparents, she started piano lessons at the age of 9, studying with the same wonderful teacher, Mrs. Husted, until she left for college. Her grandparents were Lorraine's biggest fans, never missing a single recital. As children, she and her siblings lived for Halloween, Christmas, and their yearly trip to Disneyland. Summers were spent on her steel-wheeled roller skates, riding her Schwinn one-speed bike, and swimming for 25 cents at the neighborhood park. Once a year, the family would pile into the station wagon for a trip to see friends or family in the western U.S. Once she turned 12, Lorraine babysat all of the neighborhood kids. She was a shy and quiet girl with just a few close friends, but those friends have stayed close for all these years since, and she could not imagine her life without them.
Wow. We used to sing sha la 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 ti da, sing with me now.
After graduating from Lakewood Senior High in 1977, she took some time off to work.
Come on, baby, break it down.
In 1978, her youngest sister Barbara was tragically killed. Lorraine then decided to study piano at Long Beach State, later transferring to Arizona State, where she graduated in 1982 with a BA in music. Bow, ba ba doom doom doom.
Oh, pretty woman, walking down the street, pretty woman, I kinda like to meet, pretty woman. I don't believe you, nothing true, no one can look.
Back home again in Long Beach, her first job was with the Long Beach Symphony, working in administration and box office.
Such a pretty woman, won't you pardon me, pretty woman?
Family is, and always has been, extremely important to Lorraine.
Are you lonely just like me?
Eventually, she moved to Northern California, where she met Aaron in 1988. Her family had stopped attending church when she was 10, and her teenage years found her longing for some spirituality. She was inspired by Aaron and his family, and decided to delve into her own Jewish roots. She officially joined the Jewish faith upon getting engaged, and she and Aaron were married in 1990.
And you need some love and care, and nothing, oh, nothing is going right. Just close your eyes and think.
Daughter Olivia arrived the next year.
To brighten up, oh, even your darkest night. You just call out my name.
And the family was completed when Joey was born 4 years later.
I'll come running to see you again.
Becoming a stay-at-home mom, life was good as they moved following Erin's career from Michigan to Massachusetts. She got involved with Sisterhood while Olivia was a baby and received 2 Women of the Year awards in Ann Arbor. When Joey was a toddler, Lorraine became active in Hadassah. While in Massachusetts, she was selected to go on a young women's mission to Israel and was honored again as Woman of the Year, this time by the Lynn Swamp Scott Marblehead Hadassah chapter of Hadassah.
And full of clouds, and that old cold north wind should begin to blow.
The Thals moved to Rancho Penasquitos in 2001, where she continued to volunteer. They joined Temple Adat Shalom in 2002. And by 2003, Lorraine was a vital member of Sisterhood. She became the accompanist for activities such as Sisterhood Shabbat and the annual Purim Spiel, and later the Women's Seder.
Wherever I am, I'll come running.
2003 was also when she began her tenure on the Sisterhood Board, first as recording secretary, then editor of The Happenings. She's continued in her capacity as editor, even through terms as co-executive vice president, co-sisterhood president, and financial secretary.
Oh, ain't it good to know you've got a friend.
In addition to all she was doing for Sisterhood and the temple, she also found the opportunity to go play with family, to spend time with good friends, and to celebrate with all when it came time for the bat mitzvah of Olivia and the bar mitzvah of Joey. She became recording secretary for the temple board in 2006 and served in that capacity until June of 2011. Additionally, she is still the piano accompanist for the Purim Spiels and Sisterhood Shabbat services, as well as the Women's Seder and various other services. She's an integral member of our TAS Simchat Shabbat band.
All you gotta do is call, and I will be there, yeah, yes, I'll be there.
Lorraine currently serves on the Marketing and Publicity, Adult Education, Ways and Means, and Music Committees. She's also been the driving force behind the Mossad Shalom bagel sales for many years. This year, she's coordinating the music and entertainment for the San Diego Jewish Food Festival in April.
Well, I said everybody here tonight, it's feeling.
In 2007, she earned a graphic design certificate from San Diego Continuing Education and has managed a part-time career in graphic design. In 2008, she earned a 4th Woman of the Year award from the Yachad Group of Hadassah in San Diego. If her days aren't full enough, Lorraine is now the executive assistant to Congregation Bethel in La Jolla. In 2010, she became an adult bat mitzvah, which was a centerpiece of her journey to her Jewish beginnings. For all this and more, we are so proud to present this year's TAS Sisterhood Woman of the Year for 2011-2012, Lorraine Thal.